Alright guys, so since last episode I've leveled quite a bit. You can see I've also fused my remaining monsters. I have, right here you can see the fusion. I'll show you. So this is how this started. I went from, I used my muddy hand and fro-fry to make jargon. For this one, I used my she-slime and my, my snail thing over there to make the, weakened beacon. And for him, I used the bird I had caught in the snow, isolation. And my killer, killer petal, I think that's what it's called, to make, this guy, the Argon Lizard. Also, I've got, the Mudman, the snail slime, and I think this is Boring Bee. I think that's his name. I'll show you fusions on them as well. Let's see. Something real quick. So I made the Mudman by fusing my ghost and my mischievous Mo. This one, my Mohawk slime, and Joe Cat, and for this guy, the Spike Bunny, and the Swarm that I got in the Worm Cave. Not really hard to find these guys to fuse these guys, but yeah, I'm all ready now. I'm gonna take on the next challenge for the tournament. Shouldn't be hard at all. I hope at least. I wanted to make sure I was properly leveled back up for this next part. So let's try and clear rank D. Fear not, friend. Even if your team gets beat, you won't lose a single coin. And here's rank D. So I was right, this is a piece of cake for the level I've become. Rank D, round 2. Wow. I wouldn't recommend making the beacon thing that I did. Well, too late for me now, and I'm not going to level a hill slime back up to this level. But I'd recommend sticking with the hill slime or the she slime I had last video, and just using them because they get a lot more heals. I don't know why I gave him the inherited power, but he seems to only want to use heal. That's it. And I didn't look to see if he had all the other powers. I don't know. The human brother triumphs in round two. It's the third and final round. Can the brother dig it? I can dig it, my mole friend, moly friend. Oh, look at these new guys. Carnivines. Weird dance. Oh. Finish this off, quick. Done. Round three finished. Whoa, hey, the spiky headed dude from Topside wins rank D. Let it be said, we moles now know how to reward greatness. Here's your prize. A pair of metal claws. That'll come in handy, I'm sure. I promise to tell you about a happening place, and I'm a mole of my word. It's a treacherous terrain. We locals like to call Craggravation. At the top of those cliffs, you'll find a bona fide VIP in residence. One of the very greatest of all beasts. Have yourself a little powwow with that great beast and see what's up. A great beast. A great beast. No less. I wonder. I've been studying some dusty tombs, and I've unearthed an interesting tidbit. Apparently, in the dim and distant past, the people here escaped this island. They did it by hitching a ride on the back of a giant bird. Can you imagine? If this great beast turns out to be that bird, it could be our ticket home. I can't imagine it. Well, it looks like we're gonna take a trip to Craggravation. The new region. Let's see if see what we can do about equipping that metal claw. Alright, let me issue a few of my skill points. Give me a second. Alright, well, we're gonna head to Craggravation. That's cool, it's dawn, so I'd rather travel with the sunlight than without. I'm gonna catch some of these guys. See if we can scout us some scorpions. Get rid of a few of them. Mechamai. And we need to grab a scorpion. I hit that wrong stick. Why do I keep doing it? Try and grab us that flame monster. It's a pretty small flame monster. Got him. Alright. Well, in the next part, we will welcome Dancing into our group and continue on through the Crag Ravation. See you then.